Fox News is weighing in on the newest COVID bill. They're calling it phase 3.5. And they're boosting the idea of Mitch McConnell, which is, hey, screw the states. Screw the states. Screw the cities. Let them go bankrupt. We don't really care. So Steve Ducey is gonna push that theory here. Take a look.
But what Mitch McConnell was just talking about on that radio show, you know, while it may anger the state of New Jersey, the governor here, there are some who say that that is actually a smart thing to do, because if you have another $500 billion in stimulus for a lot of states, you know, if a state were to do what some cities are able to do and declare bankruptcy, they could reduce pensions, bond debt. Currently off limits to states, however, some cities can do it. Art Laffer looks at that question about whether the states, and there are a particular number that really need it, and why. He talked about it last night on The Story with Martha.
When I listen to the discussion of the states, especially Connecticut, especially Illinois, especially New Jersey, these states have been so bad in their fiscal controls that they have run out of money. They're in bad shape. People are leaving the states in droves. And then they want the federal government to bail them out? I don't think so. I mean, this is their problem. I mean, is Illinois, Michigan, New York, Connecticut, New Jersey, these states have had a big problem long before coronavirus came. And coronavirus came along and just popped them. And they don't need to be bailed out.
He said they don't need to be bailed out. Yes, they do. Which is why they're asking for it. And that same criticism that Art Laffer just had about the states, like, oh, they had a lot of pre-existing problems, and this isn't, I mean, what do you expect? Do you expect the federal government to rush in and save them when there were issues before coronavirus? That argument can absolutely be used against all the corporations that just got bailed out. They had pre-existing problems. They did not have a rainy day fund in case something like this happened. But Art Laffer and all the other conservatives never said that to executives and owners and shareholders and the wealthy and any multinational corporations. In fact, they turned around and said, absolutely. Here's the key to the treasury. Go ahead and loot it. So we gave $4.5 trillion. Basically, all of it going to a corporate bailout. At Steve Mnuchin, the Treasury Secretary's discretion, he gets to pick who. There's no oversight. And they're totally down with that, fully implementing corporate socialism. They never said, here, pull yourself up by your bootstraps. But for the states, they go, pull yourself up by your bootstraps. Okay, how many times has Trump said, and he has in these press conferences, you know, they're asking us to do a lot of things that are not in the purview of the federal government. What we need the states to do is, you guys have to step up and do more testing and build more hospitals and look after your own people. That's what you have to do. So Trump turns around and tells them, you guys got to step up and do your part. The states do that. And then they go, oh, we just need funding for this. And the federal government goes, yeah, no, we're not going to give you any funding. So you tell them to step up, and then they don't have the money, and then you won't help them. Do you realize how ridiculous this is? Because, guys, the states don't have their own sovereign currency. The states can't make the money printer go burr. They can't do it. The federal government can, and the federal government has been doing that when it comes to raining money on big banks and financial institutions. But they don't have money for the states? I mean, it really is, it's absurd, and it shows you what their mindset is, and it shows you that this was all a scam. This was Naomi Klein's shock doctrine 101, is what this was. Oh, we have an opportunity now. What's the opportunity? Just give all the corporations the key to the treasury and sit back and let them run everything, and we have corporate socialism permanently. They always wanted that, and now they have it, and they have the nerve to turn around and make these bootstrap arguments for states that are actually stepping up to try to help their people during COVID-19. It really is unbelievable. And then, I don't know if you heard it, Steve Ducey gave away the game there for a second. And this is something perhaps he wished he had back, and he didn't say it, because This was a mask-off moment. Mask slipped here. He said, oh, well, we shouldn't bail them out because they could just go through bankruptcy, because really what they need to do is reduce pensions. Oh, okay. Okay. So use the crisis to screw working people and get rid of pensions. Got it. So that's what it's all about. So, you know, if you're keeping score here, the corporate owners and the CEOs and the top 1% and the shareholders, they cannot lose under any circumstance. They privatize the profits and then they socialize the losses, and no matter what, they're running out the back door with all the money. So they can never lose. But when it comes to working people, you don't have to even make a bad decision. You don't have to screw up, and they want to screw you over. They want to reduce the pensions. So I just want everybody to understand here, because, you know, there's been this new rebranding exercise on the right, and Republicans have tried to play the role of like, who, us, bro? No, we're like pro-worker. We're like super populist and stuff, bro. We're gonna fight for the working people. That's what we do, bro. And then you see the reality in a situation like this, where they have all this bailout money for all the corporations and all the executives and the freaking cruise line industry who pay zero taxes and has indentured servants from other countries working there. All the money in the world for them. But when it comes to, hey, help the states out because they're stepping up for coronavirus and they don't have the funds, they're like, why don't, how about you just file for bankruptcy? File for bankruptcy and reduce pensions, because that's what it's all about. That's what they want to do anyway. And listen, hear me now, quote me later. They will absolutely use the increase that's now happening with the debt and the deficit. They'll use this to turn around and tell people, we have to reduce Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid, obviously. Like, oh my God, look at all the debt. Oh, we messed up. Look at the debt and look at the deficit. Oh my God, I can't believe who spent all this money. Who spent all this money and where'd it go? Where'd it go? Well, there's only one answer now. Gotta reduce Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security. This is what they're gonna do. This is what the Republicans are gonna do. And the Democrats will probably go right along with them, but they'll, you know, try to soften the blow and use more Weasley language. And but this is what, that's what they're gonna do. So in other words, when it comes time, like, oh, let's try to balance the budget here, they will absolutely do it on the backs of regular people. There's no way they'll be like, oh, would you look at that? Why did we give 83% of the tax cuts to the top 1% in 2017? We shouldn't have given the rich that much money. Never. They will never say that. They will never say, oh my goodness, look at this military budget. Well, this is really through the roof, isn't it? We're spending more than the next 10 biggest countries combined. That's absurd. Never. They will always go to the programs that help working people. And here you go. This is an example of it right here. Oh, we're not going to give you any bailout money, because some of that money might go towards pensions for regular people, and obviously our position is screw regular people. Well, thank you for showing everybody who you really are. And, you know, I would love to see them put that foot forward instead of lying all the time. Go ahead, put that foot forward so that the voters know. Because I think they would make, you know, some different decisions had they known all along. Like, oh, so you're just here to screw me. That's right, they are.